And so that night, I asked Christ to come into my heart. I said, Lord, I just sense so much your presence here, but is it really you, or is this emotion? Mm-hmm. If you are the God of the universe and Jesus Christ is really the Savior of the world and wants to be my Savior, let me know that tonight. Mm-hmm. Within a couple of seconds, I just suddenly knew. I just knew that Jesus was alive, that he was the Savior, the Savior for all of us, and he wanted to be my personal Savior. And so I accepted him that night.
So at that time, everything began to make sense to Tom Netherton.
Yeah, interesting too. All the theological terms that we hear, all of a sudden came together. They made sense.
You understood the aspect of sin.
Yeah, all of a sudden there was sin, redemption, the blood, the Lamb of God, Jesus, Savior, the Holy Spirit,
the Spirit, God the Father.
Yeah.
Convicting you of sin.
Yeah.
And you had that desire to turn away from sin and to trust in Jesus Christ, who he is, and what he did on the cross, his death.
Exactly. Exactly.
Taking in substitution for Tom Netherton, RoxAnne Tauriello, the full punishment and penalty for our sins, dying and rising again. And you receive Jesus Christ as your own personal Savior. And God forgives your sin. You begin to have a relationship with him, that assurance of life eternal. Now, you mentioned the next day that you went to see a Billy Graham film.
You read the book.
An altar call, a wonderful, wonderful book. Let me say, the book is Tom Netherton, In the Morning of My Life. What a wonderful book, Tom. And an altar call is given, and you sit there for a moment, motionless.
Mm-hmm.
What's running through your mind, Tom?
Well, it's interesting because the night before I accepted Christ in my heart, but something said, even though there was an altar call,
mm-hmm.
something said, don't go forward tonight. I want you to go forward tomorrow night at the movie.
Mm-hmm. Of course, you were saved the moment you came to repentance.
Oh, yeah, I was saved.
But the Spirit of God was just telling you something like that.
Because he knew it was going to be much easier. It was going to be for that public display of my conversion and my acceptance of Christ. God knew it was going to be tougher the next day because so many people in the church were going forward. It'd be easy to just kind of get up and go down with everybody. But there at the movie, I thought, well, all my men are here, a lot of my men are here for my company. I'm an officer, and these guys, they're looking at me. And a lot of all these people, they're going to think, well.
You wouldn't stand up and be unnoticed.
Exactly.
How tall is Tom Netherton?
I'm 6'5", 6'5", and I thought, oh, they're going to think maybe I'm a religious nut or something, And then suddenly it just hit me. I said, wait a minute, I just met the God of the universe.
Amen.
I met his son, Christ. I want to tell the whole world, and I just jumped up, and I think I was the first person down there standing there, and I was just proud to stand down there. No matter what, I mean, you can be, Donald Trump, you can be, you can have all kinds of money, you can have hotels named after you, you can have buildings named after you, but what does it all mean if your life doesn't count for eternity?
Exactly.
And that's what I finally came to realize, is that everything else that you do, your fame, your name,
temporary.
Money, cars, it's all temporary.
All temporary. You die and you leave it behind, either to enter into heaven or hell.
Mm-hmm.
That Bible verse, what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? I believe, was it 1973, am I right? God begins to open a wonderful door of opportunity for you.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us about that.
Yeah, it was just incredible. I was singing in a show in North Dakota.
Yes.
The Badlands of North Dakota. It was the Medora musical.
Mm-hmm.
And the owners of the show, fantastic people, just love them to get to death. And their Harold was the president of the Gold Seal Company that made Snowy, Bleach, Mr. Bubble, Bubble Bath, and all that. And so very successful in North Dakota. And so a lot of people from North Dakota, it's a small state, know each other who are famous or who are, successful. Anyway, they knew Lawrence, and they saw me in their show, and they heard me sing in a chapel one Sunday morning in a little teeny town, even smaller than where I was singing. And they said, you really believe what you sing, don't you, Tom? I said, yeah, I really do. And they said, we thought so, and we'd like to talk to our friend Lawrence Welk about you. And he was coming up for a family reunion, so they arranged a meeting, mm-hmm. and I met him on the golf course.
You met him on the golf course?
On the golf course.
And who did you take with you?
Well, we weren't sure whether I was going to sing mm-hmm. for him or not, but just in case, we did bring the piano player from the yeah. show.
Now, he said something to your friend about if you sing, if he asks you to sing three songs, what does that mean?
Actually, it was to Mrs. Schaefer.
Yes.
She was there with Lawrence, mm-hmm. and he asked, he told her, he said, I want you to know, if I ask him to sing a second song, that means I really like him.
So, and how many songs did you sing?
Yeah, so then he asked me to sing a second song. She was just beaming. I thought, why is she, you know, she's mm-hmm. so happy. Because she knew what was going on. And then I sang that song for him again. And then he invited me to the St. Paul Civic Center.
Tell us what happens there.
Yeah,
that was amazing.
That was so neat. That was a couple of months
please.
In October, just a couple months later. And it was the largest audience they had, live audience they had
yes.
ever played to. It was over 19,000 people. Mm-hmm. And because I arrived there and saw everybody coming from the show, you know, Myron and Guy and Roma and Anna Connie mm-hmm. and everybody, and I was Bobby and Sissy, and I was so excited to see everybody.
Mm-hmm. Was it like you expected? I mean, looking at the star stage
oh,
door.
Yeah, it was just, yeah, it was so exciting. Just all these people, it was, you know, just amazing. And then, anyway, it came time for me to be introduced, mm-hmm. Lawrence. He said, well, are you nervous, Tom?
Mm-hmm.
I said, yes, sir, I am. He says, oh, that's a good sign. That's a good sign.
But then
he went up the stairs, and it was unusual the way they had it, because in stairs, usually the stairs going up the side, and this was stairs going up the back. And anyway, so he introduced me, and as I started to walk up the stairs then, I realized I had given this whole thing to the Lord. And I said, you know, Lord, if this works out, that would be my heart's desire, but I want what you want. Mm-hmm. And if it doesn't work out, then just thank you for a great opportunity and a wonderful memory that I'll always
How
have.
Wonderful.
And so all of a sudden the nervousness left, and I went out and I sang I Asked the Lord. The people were wonderful, asked for an encore, and mm-hmm. then I had to sing again and sang another one, and then Lawrence came out and he went, wow, look at that, Tom. You know something, the audience is never wrong. And then he said, will you come out and do our TV show? And of course, everybody went crazy then. You know, God's been really good to me, and I love it. You know, it's what's wonderful is when you know that it's a passion in your life,
yes.
that God's put it in your heart, and you love to do it, and you know it's his gift.